of the era. Under manager Don Revie, they'd experienced a decade of unprecedented success, transformed from second division strugglers into league champions, and had won cups at home and in Europe. For viewers at the time, these names would have needed little by way of introduction.
Harvey, age 25, goalkeeper.
David's worked very hard to get into the Leeds first team. I think he's probably been in our reserve side about 6 years, waiting for his big chance, and he finally got it. I think it was in the semi-final last year. And from then on, he's grasped it with both hands and he's played really well.
Brilliant goalkeeping!
Paul Reaney, aged 28, defender.
Paul Reaney probably had his best season for a long time, completely recovered from his broken leg now, playing with bags of confidence, and we've even nicknamed him Stan after Stanley Matthews because he's playing with such confidence.
Trevor Cherry, age 25, defender.
Trevor cost the club £90,000 from Huddersfield, and I think he said that he came to Leeds to get medals. Well, he's certainly going to have a chance to get one this afternoon. He's a very strong tackler, and very good in the air, and he's played really well for Leeds this season.
Cherry! Team captain, Billy Bremner, age 30. Midfield.
Billy's always seems to pop one in the semi-final. He always seems to book his ticket to Wembley.
Jones trying to feed on it, Brenda! 1-0!
He's done it on three occasions now. Probably in the last half a dozen games, he's really started to play well, create inspiration to all the other boys. Never seems to stop running.
Oh, great goal by Brenda!
Paul Madeley, age 28, defender.
Well, what can you say about Paul Madeley? He could be playing in goal today, I think. Can play any position you want him to play. Super footballer. He's got power to spare, really. Probably the most complete footballer in England today.
Norman Hunter, age 29, defender.
Norman Hunter, supposed to be a hard man. I'm very friendly with Norman, and he's a gentleman off the field, really. A lot of these reporters keep saying he's one-footed, but if I'd got a left foot like him, it'd do me, actually.
Peter Lorimer, age 26, forward.
The nickname Peter Lash, obviously because he's got the hottest shot in football.
It's well, in comes Lorimer.
You could probably not see Peter in a game for half an hour, then suddenly a ball will break for him and he'll let fly with his right leg and Leeds suddenly one up. It's frightening. I'm glad he plays for Leeds and not anybody else.
Alan Clark, age 26, forward.
He's got a good nickname, Sniffer. Clarke, he depends a lot on feeding off Mick Jones, who's probably the workhorse of the side, and anywhere inside the box is like lightning.
Mick Jones, age 28, forward.
Mick Jones is probably the most underrated player in the team. He doesn't get a lot of credit for what he does, but I know the lads appreciate him. Very unselfish, and he never stops running in the whole 90 minutes. He's having a little trouble with getting a pair of boots that won't go out of shape for his feet at the moment, so we're trying to fix him up with a decent pair. And I think at Wembley we might turn it on again today.
Johnny Giles, aged 31, midfield.
Johnny Giles, great competitor. Two brilliant feet. He can pick a man off 50 yards away.
Look at that pass!
Good at short passing. Very skillful. Thinks a lot about the game and is always encouraging the younger boys. Terrific player to play with.
Eddie Gray, aged 25, midfield.
Eddie's been very unlucky with injuries this year again. I hope today that he's feeling good, because I'm sure if he's feeling good, he's going to be one of our match winners. As soon as he gets the ball, the crowd starts buzzing and they're expectant. And if he's on form, God help this Sunderland.
Fullback Terry Cooper ruled out for the whole of that season with a broken leg, giving us the lowdown on the Leeds players. Described by coach Arthur Cox.
Jim Montgomery, age 29, goalkeeper.
When you think of Jimmy, you automatically think of quick reflexes, good size pair of hands, very courageous, and amongst young players, an experienced head. It's my certain size which have been above the call of normal duty, particularly during the cup run.
Brilliant save!
Dick Malone, age 25, defender.
Dickie has worked at his game very, very hard in the last 4 or 5 months, and to his credit, has proven himself more than a competent defender, as well as a very, very good attacking fullback. He's now finding aggression.
Ron Guthrie, aged 29, defender.
When I came to the North East, certain people were good enough to inform me on what to expect from Geordies. Doer, tough, honest day's work for an honest day's pay. Loves to come forward, loves to play. This is Ronnie Guthrie.
Mick Horswell, age 20, midfield.
Michael has a certain amount of knobby styles in him. He's a terrier, he's a worker. He battles, he typifies the team in as much as he doesn't want to be beaten.
Dave Watson, age 25, defender.
Well, the big man's as good a professional as there is in football. Very, very good in the air. Strong, two good feet, quick, brave.
Hughes can make it, but Watson did!
He doesn't have the tight control which in McFarlane's have, but his defensive qualities are greater than what McFarlane's are.
Richie Pitt, age 21, defender.
Richie's always had ability, particularly in the air, and when he's playing to his strengths, which is dispossessing forwards and using it as early as he possibly can, he looks a good player.
Team captain Bobby Kerr, age 25, midfield.
They say all good things come in small packages. Sets a wonderful example on the field to the rest of the team. Always encouraging. Bob is no mean performer. Looks to get into holes that appear in defences. Tremendous competitor.
Billy Hughes, age 24, forward.
Billy's a handful for any defender at any class. He's very, very confident at the moment. He's a superb athlete. Very, very quick. Billy gets in wing positions at the dead ball line and can produce crosses which manufacture goals for other people. Billy's been an outstanding performer for us during our cup run.
Vic Hallam, age 24, forward.
We think Vic leads our line like Bobby Smith and Nat Loftus led Tottenham and Bolton's lines. An old-fashioned type of centre-forward. Gets out behind the full-backs, controls it, merges it into play. His enthusiasm rubs off on others.
Oh, he really tanked that!
Ian Porterfield, age 25, midfield.
Ian plays left side for us, midfield. Links up very well with Billy Hughes and Dennis Stewart. Has a wonderful touch on the ball, with it, particularly on his left side. Acts as a true midfield player, looks for it from behind, looks for it coming back from the front men.
Dennis Stewart, age 23, forward.
Dennis is more than a handful for all defenders. Tremendously skillful, very quick, always looks to go at people.
Cup final mania had gripped everyone, and as the big day arrived, thousands made plans to journey from the northeast by road and rail. And Tony Gubber was on board one of 14 Wembley-bound trains.
The ticket for the match?
That's correct, yes, that's right.
How are you going to get in?
Well, we'll hope to be able to get tickets down there.
Well, according to the papers this morning, that's going to cost you a lot of money on the black market.
Yeah, well, I think according to the papers, every year would sold us the same. But a friend at work who was down the Centenary Cup final last year, the Centenary Cup final, got a ticket easily at 10 to 3, 5 to 3. But we're giving them away, and we're expecting the same thing this year, even though the papers say different.
Well, some of the figures quoted this morning have been £150 for a seat. Are you prepared to pay that much?
No chance.
How much are you going to pay?
Well, I would hate to think we had to pay anything over £10 for a ticket for a football match, even though it is a cup final.
Well, don't you feel it's a long way to go on spec and just on the chance of getting a ticket and getting in?
Well, the atmosphere, isn't it? You know, the Wembley Cup final. I mean, Leeds supporters, fair enough, they've been there three times in 4 years, but how long is it before Sunderland get there again? You know, once, maybe it's in a lifetime. Yeah, I think it must go.
I think you must certainly be the prettiest supporter on the train.
Well, I would hope so. I'm this year's Miss Sunderland AFC.
What's that, the official Sunderland Football Club beauty queen?
Yes, I was appointed last August and last 3 years.
Some of the fans on the train haven't got tickets to actually get into Wembley. I presume you've got one.
Yes, I've got one for me and then one for my mum.
Supplied, what, by courtesy of Sunderland?
Yes, by a football club.
What about a result? Come on, give us a result.
Well, I think it'll be 3-1.
Confidence.
For
why?
Sunderland.
Why?
Well, I got this hat given this morning and it's got four ribbons on and three of them are cut one way and the other one's cut the other way. So I think that's three goals for Sunderland and one for Leeds.
It might be three goals for Leeds and one for Sunderland.
Oh, no, that could never be.
Food among the lads this morning at the hotel seemed very relaxed, Ron. Is that a fair indication?
Oh, very relaxed indeed, you know, a few jokes and that. Good carry on.
Let's move on to Jim Montgomery. You've been to Wembley before, but never actually played on the pitch, Jim. How are you looking forward to it?
Oh, tremendous. You know, like, when you come out and see this and the fans and the atmosphere, it's fantastic. And the pitch itself, tremendous.
How have you managed to stay so relaxed, the lads, through all this build-up this week?
Well, we feel that the onus is on Leeds. We're the underdogs. We can relax. It's up to Leeds. They've got to watch us, like, you know what I mean?
What about the feeling among the players about the pitch? You have a look at it now. I mean, is it in good condition?
Oh, it's pretty good, yeah. You know, I mean, well, the other day when we looked at it, you know, it's we're disappointed, but I mean, it's still brilliant, you know. We'll do well on it.
The Leeds players were saying this morning that the rain has helped them more than they think it might have helped you. How do you react to that?
I shouldn't think that, really. Just the same. Just got to fight it out.
Richie Pitt, what's your first reaction to Wembley?
Oh, it's fantastic. The crowd actually made the occasion. It's a fantastic stadium, and the whole crowd are the best ever.
What was the coach journey like? You're still all in very high spirits.
Oh, yes. We're all having a game of cards to try and ease the nerves a little bit. We're getting a bit nervous now, but I don't think we're as bad as I anticipated.
The lads seem to be able to cope with the occasion very well up to now. No, are the nerves beginning to show now, do you think?
Not really. The lads are quite relaxed. You've seen yourself, you know. It's, I don't know what's wrong, really. What's wrong with us? Is it wrong, like? Is it?
Sir, David Harvey and Paul Rennie now from Leeds United. Let's have a view on that pitch, David. What's it looking like?
It's very good. Well, always is very good, but it's nice to be back on it again, you know.
Will that rain this morning have made it a little bit sticky on top, with the ball shooting through a bit, perhaps, or are you worried about that?
No, I don't think it'll get sticky. I think it'll just shoot off the top, you know.
Is that going to worry you as a goalkeeper?
Well, it doesn't help very much, you know, but some of these things you've got to overcome.
You're still feeling very confident, are you?
Yeah, I always feel confident.
The nerves beginning to build up now?
No, another half an hour just.
Paul, what about the routine in the dressing room from now on? What happens when you go back in there now?
Well, there'll be a few jokes and what have you, you know. I don't think, you know, there's still a lot of tension, but in the dressing room, it isn't so bad, you know. It isn't a matter of walking about and not knowing what to say. You know, we all know what's happened. We've all been before, and it's just a matter of now settling down for the kick-off. You know.
Norman Hunt is with us as well. What about the mood among the lads at the moment, Norman? Getting built up?
Yes, they're getting built up. They're bound to, you know, cup final day. When you come up Wembley Way and all the crowds there, you only seem to see our support, doesn't that get you going even more?
Does it seem any different when you come back? You've been so many times, but is it always the same?
Well, it gets better every time you come. First one, you can't remember much of it because you're a bit younger. Then the second, third, gets better and better as you go on.
Are your family here this afternoon?
Yes, I've got my wife and my little boy here.
Can you see them when you come out the tunnel?
I saw them as we came in the coach. We passed their coach and I saw my wife and my little lad.
So they'll be hoping to join in some celebrations tonight then?
Yes, I hope they will.
How important is the first 20 minutes, Peter? If we need to get an early goal, are we going to see a real exhibition, do you think?
I think so. I think if we can score an early goal, I think we'll put a performance like you've never seen before. I think all hinges on the early goal, you know.
Do most of the lads feel that way about today?
Yes, I think they're all confident. If we score one very early, that we could put on one of these performances we're capable of doing, you know.
I don't think you personally have scored in the cup final yet, have you?
Never, not. Every time I've been here, I've hit the woodwork. I've hit the post every time by the crossbar. One of these days, something's going to happen.
I've seen since I came into the stadium, around the stadium, you know, it convinces me that what I thought this morning was right, that I think Sunderland have a great chance of winning. And when they quoted the price, I think it was 9-2 or something like that. It's a ridiculous price for the chance that they've got. I think that they've every chance of creating a mild sensation today. I base that view on the fact that we played Leeds a couple of weeks ago. Granted, they didn't play well, but the build-up to Wembley hasn't been good, Leeds. Sunderland, it hasn't altered at all. They've just kept on winning.
So you're going firmly for Sunderland, are you?
I would go for Sunderland, yeah.
Now, Bob Wilson, you saw Sunderland in the semi-final, which was unfortunate for you. Who are the key players? I mean, a lot's been talked about David Watson in both penalty areas.
Yeah, absolutely right, too, David. Actually, particularly today, it'll be his role at the back that'll be important, because in the early stages, I'm certain Leeds will be putting some sort of pressure. They've got all the experience. They'll be putting pressure on the defence. And I think that the goalkeeper, Jim Montgomery, and David Watson, if they can look inspired, they'll inspire the rest of the team.
So who are you going for?
I'm going for Leeds. I'm sorry, but I think, like Bobby, I think there's tremendous emotion here from this fantastic crowd. But I can't possibly get away from the Leeds' overall skill and ability.
Terry Cooper?
Well, I'm naturally biased towards Leeds. I don't think there's any way Sunderland can win the cup this afternoon. I'm basing this on, in the semi-final against Arsenal, they never stopped chasing, running. From my own experience playing out there, you just can't chase about for 90 minutes on that pitch. So, you know, skills all around, I think it's got to be Leeds.
Brian?
You've got to have reservations, David, because obviously it is still a cup tie, despite the fact it's a cup final. It's still 90 minutes and anything can happen. But clinically, there's not a single solitary thing, apart from the physical side, running power, where Sunderland can possibly win. We all used to believe in fairies at the bottom of the garden. We like these things to come true. If that happens today, then obviously everybody's dream will come true and Sunderland would win. But it is impossible to be, I don't know, anything but certain that Leeds will beat Sunderland in today's cup.
Bird's eye view from our helicopter camera of the great stadium, which today can look back on 50 years of FA Cup finals, beginning in 1923 with the match that's still talked about between West Ham and Bolton Wanderers, the match in which the policeman on the white horse became famous. The stadium already packed. And this, possibly, in the 50 years of cup finals at Wembley, the most partisan crowd in the history of the FA Cup. Sunderland from the second division, bidding to become today the first second division side since 1931 to win the trophy. And these Sunderland supporters have no doubt about the capacity of their side to do just that. And so they emerge into the daylight of Wembley Stadium. Kerr, the Sunderland captain, Jim Montgomery, goalkeeper, Richie Pitt, one of the back four, Mick Horswill, only 20, Dick Malone, the right back, David Watson, the number five. Two teams lining up now for the official presentation. His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent, President of the Football Association, accompanied by Sir Andrew Stephen, the Chairman of the Football Association. The Duke of Kent going to the Leeds side, Billy Bramner, the captain, introducing David Harvey, Leeds United, the FA Cup holders, and Don Revy, the manager, whose president is, of course, a member of the royal family, Lord Harwin. And as the presentations are made, and the president of the FA talks to Billy Bremner, the rain beginning to stream down. The skies have opened, and it really is cascading onto the players. It's Bobby Kerr, the Sunderland captain. Jim Montgomery, the goalkeeper. Billy Hughes, one of the strikers, just hidden there. It may well be Dennis Stewart. That's David Young, the substitute. And finally, Bob Stoker. The match officials, Mr. Burns, the referee. Bob Stoker happy enough. Last word with the players. Sunderland breaking towards the end where the supporters are. And at the opposite end, the roar is for the salute of the Leeds players. The Leeds United side. Only one change from the team that won the FA Cup 12 months ago. Jack Charlton not fit. Trevor Cherry plays with number three on his back. And Paul Madeley, who played left back 12 months ago, moves to number five. And incidentally, every member of the Leeds United side, an international, except Trevor Cherry, who's in his first season with the club. The substitute, too, is a full international, Terry Yorath of Wales. Now, the Sunderland side. And by comparison, Sunderland with only one player who's ever played at Wembley, Richie Pitt, who appeared as a schoolboy international. The two captains meeting in the middle of the pitch. The two smallest captains ever in an FA Cup final. Bobby Kerr's only 5 feet four, and Billy Bremner looks down on him from 5 feet five. And the first battle's been won by Bobby Kerr, who clearly won the toss and chose the way to play.
Well,
And it looks as if the team's changing. That's David Watson, the centre-back for Sunderland, £100,000 from Rotherham United. Number 11, Dennis Stewart, the Sunderland penalty taker and striker. Billy Hughes, another of the strikers, who scored what turned out to be the winning goal in the semi-final against Arsenal. Don Revie settling down on the Leeds bench, Les Cocker, the trainer, beside him. David Harvey, who's taken over from Gary Sprake and made the goalkeeping position his own. Eddie Gray back to the side after fitness. And so, Leeds United, the FA Cup holders, kick off, the rain settled down to drizzle, and this Wembley turf, the promised land for so many FA Cup.